I wanted to discuss with you, Psyche, there's a lot of information out there that people are saying, okay, well, this is the reason that inflation is high. No, this is the reason that inflation is high. So I want to try to tease out some of these contributing factors and see if we can get to the bottom of it. So one of the things is the supply shortages, right? So you hear some people say, well, I think inflation is actually going to cool off a little bit as time progresses because the kinks that were in the supply chain as a result of all the COVID stuff, those are going to start to work themselves out, smooth out. And as the supply chain gets moving again, inflation should ease somewhat. You've also got a different group of people that are saying, well, it's not just the supply chain, or maybe it's not even the supply chain. It's the fact that over the course of the last 2 years, the government has borrowed trillions upon trillions upon trillions of dollars and basically flushed all that into the economy. So there's a massive influx of cash into the economy. So a lot of people have money to spend. So that's driven demand very high. And then you've got people that have talked about, interest rates have been relaxed for far too long and money is cheap, which is different from being plentiful. Money being cheap means it's easy to borrow. And they'll say that's what's going on that's causing the inflation. So based on what you see, and based on your thoughts and experience, I'd like to know kind of where you stand with all that and how you expect things to play out maybe in the next year or two.
Yeah, certainly. So this might not clarify it for everybody, but I think it's a little bit of all of it, right? I think it started when COVID came and we started locking down and people, shut down. We stopped working pretty much as a country. And there were certain products and items that just weren't being manufactured anymore. And there's a lot of products and items that people were trying to just go buy in bulk and hold on to. So you were seeing shortages. Then, as that happened, which was unprecedented for us, right? We'd never been through that as a country. Our reaction to that as a country was let's kind of deploy a lot of money into our economy. Let's get it kickstarted again. So that further created an issue because now you've got more dollars in the system and people are spending. And if they're out there spending, they're out there buying. And if they're buying, you're not going to have enough supply where you already don't have enough supply because everybody shut down. So now that created more of a demand because now the average person had more savings in their checking account in their lifestyle, right? They have more money in their pocket from the money. It's been proven from reports. So there's what do people do when we have more money? The average human person spends more. So now we're locked down, we're spending more with this free money. And as the economy rolls back up again, then another strike of COVID. So some we get partially shut down and we go through this for 2 years. Well, meanwhile, while we're doing this for 2 years, we do have easy money, as you call it. Interest rates have been artificially lowered to keep money flowing through the system. What people need to remember is our system is based on consumption. That's how we function as a country. If we don't buy, it falls apart. So that we're based on that. We have to spend money as the consumers, the general public. So all of that has led to where we are right now.